Dear fellow Quincy residents, my name is David Jacobs, and I am a first-time candidate for Quincy School Committee. I want to thank you for taking the opportunity to tune in to watch these candidate videos. I grew up in Quincy in the neighborhood of Howes Neck. Growing up, my siblings and I all attended Quincy Public Schools. School for me was always exciting, but the learning part never came easy. Early in my education, I was diagnosed with a learning disability. Because of this, when I first began school, I was educated in a substantially separate classroom. Eventually, I was mainstreamed into the general education setting and discovered my passion in history. Even though school was challenging for me, I never let it get the best of me. I attribute most, if not all of that, to my family and the dedicated Quincy Public School teachers. Before graduating from Quincy Public Schools in 2005, I began looking into different colleges. I sat down with my parents and told them I really wanted to work in education. My parents seemed a little surprised by my choice because I had struggled so much in school. I told them that was exactly why I wanted to become an educator. I wanted to help students who had faced difficulties just like me. I decided to attend Salem State University because I was given the opportunity to attend school in a very historic town and also the opportunity to work as a park ranger, providing educational programs and tours at numerous historic sites across the North Shore. This was a dream job for a young man studying history and education. I was afforded this opportunity because while in high school, I volunteered at the Adams National Historical Park in Quincy. After graduating college, I was able to see the country working for the National Park Service. I worked in South Dakota, Nebraska, and Florida. My last post with the National Park Service brought me back home to Adams National Historical Park, right here in Quincy, working as a museum educator and special programs coordinator. I like to say I traveled around the country on John Adams. For the last 6 years, I have been working in the Boston Public Schools. I have worked in general education, special education, and full inclusion classrooms. I know what works in a classroom, and I know what does not. My firsthand experience and knowledge of how school systems function and misfunction make me a good candidate for school committee. I'm running to bring equitable opportunity for students to participate in Quincy's educational programs. We currently have numerous programs that run across many schools in the district. Our instructors who facilitate these programs are forced to work very complex schedules that are developed by school administrators. Because our staff are forced to bounce from school to school, they aren't afforded the control to set their own schedules to meet with their students. This causes a far too common practice of pulling students out of their core academic courses or simply not allowing them a full-rounded educational experience. This practice pits teachers against one another and often makes the student feel as though there is no good option. The district needs to make this practice the exception and not the rule. With leadership and proper management, we can make collaborative inter-school schedules that would work better for students and teachers and cause a resurgence in programs that have been dwindling over the past few decades. I also believe that with all the increased testing going on in schools, especially at the lower grade levels, we have limited what was once one of the best joys of childhood, recess. Recently, while knocking doors in a few Quincy neighborhoods, it came to my attention that recess is being limited and that certain fields are being designated no-go areas for students during school hours. I want to make sure that students are getting adequate recess time every day. As a licensed educator, I understand the challenges our teachers and students face every day in the classroom. As a teacher of students with disabilities and an uncle of a student with an IEP, I understand the importance of following the IEP as written and offering appropriate, inclusive programming to our students with disabilities. I'm running for Quincy School Committee because it is my turn now to fight so that students don't have to pick between required courses and courses that they want to take, and so that teachers don't have to quarrel as to whether or not a student should miss class to attend another. I'm running to make Quincy Public Schools a place where teachers work in an environment where they feel they and their discipline is a valued part of the curriculum, and where students' educational requirements and desired elective studies both take precedent in helping them achieve their goals. I am running to be your voice on the Quincy School Committee. It's time for a new generation of representatives. Please visit my campaign website at www.dj4quincyschools.com. Again, I want to thank you for tuning in to these candidate videos here on QATV and staying informed. I urge you to vote on November 7th and ask that you consider me, David Jacobs, for one of your three votes for Quincy School Committee. Thank you.